Darlings, I'm Cognac Willa Lane, and we are here on the red carpet at the Macabre Fair Film Festival. I'm here with this filmmaker, who he's going to talk about his film. First of all, introduce yourself to the camera.
Yes, I am Andres Zavala. I'm here with the film A Dark Room.
A Dark Room.
Rome.
Oh, A Dark Room, like the city Rome, Italy.
Yeah,
Rome.
It.
Are you Italian?
Yes, I am Argentinian, but I work in Italy, and we made this film in Rome.
Okay. Tell my audience about this film. What's the synopsis?
It's a thriller, but it's also a black comedy. Here we have won the best thriller of 2015. And it's about a boy who gets involved in a murder. And he's working in a beauty salon for priests in Rome.
Wow.
And so he has a problem of confessing to the priest or confessing to the police. And the priests are people taking care of their image more than of our souls. So it's something also tricky about what's going on now in the Vatican with many scandals of
Oh, yes, you're right. There's a lot of scandals going on.
Exactly.
Now, if we want to find out more information about this film, do you have a website?
Yes. We have a Facebook page and we have a website, and I'll give you here more information.
A Dark Room.
Yes.
The Facebook page is?
Yes, the Facebook page is A Dark Room.
A Dark Room.
And now we have a distribution, which is 30 Holding, which is this distributor, a world sales agent. So we hope also to have it distributed in the United States, of course.
So it was,
it's in English. The film is in English.
So it was selected for 2015 Marabella International Film Festival.
There we got also a nomination for Best Story. And this is also a big festival like Macabre. This is an international festival, not horror festival, open festival.
Right. Did you show in Cannes at all?
In Canada,
No, in Cannes.
We were in TIFA, Toronto International Film Festival.
Toronto, that's big too.
Yeah, and in Spain twice, in Marbella and in Torremolinos Fantastic also.
We're
very lucky.
Are you up for any awards?
What?
Are you up for any awards here at the Macabre?
Yes, we won the Macabre Fair Film Festival Best Thriller for 2015.
Okay. Terrific. Terrific. Well, I can't wait to see what this film is going to do. Keep it going, okay?
Thank you very much. Thank you. You've been great. Thank you. Very friendly. Thank
and we'll be back in a moment, Dollies. More interviews coming up. Keep watching. Peace, champagne, kisses.
It's a dark room. Just passing by can be so scary, and you know why. You can be right in it and never know what's round the bend.
Patrick Lewis, I'm the new tattoo artist.
Good morning.
I think he's having an affair with your wife.
You little motherfucker, how dare you!
Wow, did Frank do this? And I'm sure you'll do just as good a job.
It's a very dark room, an immoral black room. It's a city fairy tale from deep down you hail.
You do feel repentant, don't you? This is not for you.
Greetings. I'm Cognac with Elaine, and I'm here with a very special star, Eileen Dietz?
No,
Dietz, right? And she is...
It sounds like die.
Right.
That doesn't.
And we know her best as the actress, right, the demon from The Exorcist. Now, tell my audience, a lot has happened in a year. Tell my audience what's going on with you now.
Shot 4 films in the past year. Two of them were horror comedies, and I shot them in New York, actually. One on Staten Island, and one in Brooklyn.
Anything showing here tonight or today?
No, but next year there's going to be like 4 films. They're not going to select 4 films, but they can choose from 4 films next year. They all shoot, and maybe a 5th one that I shot a year and a half ago. So I've been busy. I've been very lucky.
Tell my audience, you have a favorite one out of the 4.
No,
they're all good.
Yeah, each time I shoot one, it's, you know, it seems more fun than the last. I shot a thriller called Lake Alice about this time last year in Wisconsin. And it was freezing. It was 10 degrees below. But it was
so cold. This past year was so cold.
There's no wind. So that helps when there's no wind.
Yeah.
So that was really, really fun. I love that. Great cast, great people. But I just shot a horror comedy that's really insane. I mean, I play a demon. It's called A Star Star Holes. Got it?
A
Star Star Holes.
H-O-L-E-S?
Yep. So I play a demon, of course. But this demon starts out being really, really evil, and then really, really playful, and then I'm in a therapy session and I cry because I can't. Well, why doesn't anybody love me? Why can't I find love? So that film is really
hysterical.
Hysterical. So it's really fun.
Okay. If we want to check up on you and find out what's going on with you, tell my audience, do you have a website?
I have a website. It's EileenDietz.com. I kind of forget about it, and I don't keep up on it. But you can always follow me on Facebook. And it's just Eileen Dietz on Facebook. And I have a fan page there under Eileen Dietz and a regular page. And that's really the best way to find out what I'm doing.
On the fan page.
Yeah. And I should keep up with my web page. But
I know we all...
I don't tweet either. I don't get it.
I Facebook, but then it goes to my Twitter account. That's what it does with me. Now, let me ask you something. Have you seen any of the films? Or are you going to see any of the films this weekend here at the Macabre?
That's the hardest thing. Because I have a table in the vendor room. And so you're always conflicted between, you know, selling your stuff and watching films. But I didn't see anything today, but tomorrow I'm going to really try. And I'm going to do a panel about women in horror.
Okay, excellent.
That's at 3:30. And I'm going to try and see some shorts. I really love shorts.
They're the best, aren't they?
I'm short. Short loves short.
Well, Eileen, it's always a pleasure to talk to you.
Thank you.
And good luck with these films coming up in the new year. And will you give me a kiss goodbye,
darling?
Yeah.
And I'll be here next year. And the year after that. And the year after that.
And we'll be back in a moment with more interviews right here at the Macabre Fair Film Festival, darlings. Keep watching. Pink Champagne Kisses.
Be good, be scared. Thank you.
an old altar boy, Father.
Cross of the Lord, begone you hostile power. I cast you out, unclean spirit.
Shut up your ass.
In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. It is he who commands you. He who plunged heights of heaven to the depths of hell.
Fuck him.
Begone.
Fuck him, Garrus.
From
fuck
this
him.
Creature of the dead. To depart from the servant of God. It's the God and Lord of all creation.
That compels you.
The power of Christ compels you. The power of...
Se poi razumemos, pasto crevates...
You're not my mother!
Come into me!
Welcome back, darlings. I'm Cognac Willaline, and we're here at the Macabre Fair Film Festival. I'm here with these two gentlemen.
Hello.
Who they look like they're drinking Coke.
Yep, that's
Coca-Cola.
It. Coca-Cola.
Just Coca-Cola. Introduce yourself.
I'm Matt Almeida, creator, co-creator of The Indestructible.
I'm Colin Artinian, like writer, director of The Indestructible, a short film that's playing at the Macabre Fair Film Festival.
Tell my audience about this film. What is the synopsis of this film?
Well, the story is about a sort of loner kid in high school. He's bullied, and he creates his own world out of a comic book, and the comics sort of come to life, and, you know, things happen. Mayhem ensues.
Now, you wrote the story.
Colin's actually the...
You wrote the story. Yeah. Okay, tell my audience, what inspired you to write this story?
It was kind of loosely based on my own high school experience, and also I watched a lot of CNN while I was watching this movie. It's a lot of kind of what's kind of happening in the world today with all the sort of school shootings and all sorts of things like that, yeah.
What made you undertake this film?
Well, I've produced a few films now, three of Colin's and a few other ones, and he gave me the script. This was actually my favorite one he'd given me so far, because I could see the vision of how far we could actually take this beyond it being a short, and so we've been developing it for a few years. We released a couple of shorter films in between, but yeah, I fell in love with it the second I read it.
Fantastic. Tell my audience, what is the website?
You can go to www.theindestructiblefilm.com.
Terrific. Well, thank you both, guys.
Thank you so much.
Break
thank
a leg.
You.
And we'll be back in a moment, darlings. More interviews coming up. Keep watching. Champagne kisses.
He's called the Indestructible, but I mean, it's not finished yet.
Well, what does he do?
Stops evil.
How does he stop evil?
of his sort.
Nobody does the really bad people?
Himself and talk about his documentary.
My name is Brian Coddington. I'm from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, and I made House of Oddities, the story of the atrocity exhibition, which had its basic Long Island premiere here today.
House of Oddities.
Yes.
What is that all about?
I made a documentary about a group of friends of mine who are burlesque and sideshow performers in Pittsburgh, and they perform a annual basically a 360-degree art exhibition called the Atrocity Exhibition. It's been going on for 8 years.
Fascinating.
And in 2013, they asked me to basically give them a behind-the-scenes look at how this gigantic festival is put together.
Where can we go to learn more information? Do you have a website?
Yes, I do. If you go to houseofoddiesmovie.com, you can find out more information about the performers, about screenings, about you can even find copies of the film, which are for sale on.
Do you have a trailer?
Yes, I do. It can also be found on that website as well.
Okay. How long is your film?
It's about 91 minutes, so it's a feature-length film.
Tell my audience one more time the website.
houseofoddiesmovie.com.
Break a leg.
Thank you.
We'll be back in a moment, Dolly's. More interviews coming up. Keep watching. Pink Champagne Kisses. Welcome back, darlings. I'm Cognac Willa Lane, and we're here at the Macabre Fair Film Festival. I'm here with this gentleman, and he's going to talk about his film. Introduce yourself.
My name is Kev Forte. I am the creator of The Sid Reapers, and I started as Jared Scrim. And one of the other films that's just showed is Wednesday's Children, which is my brother's film, Matthew Forte. And I just help part produce it, but most of them are on The Sid Reapers Project.
So the name of the film is?
One is The Sin Reapers, and that's the one I started.
Sin Reaper, S-I-N Reapers, R-E-A-P-E-R-S.
Yep. Exactly.
And this lovely young lady, introduce yourself.
I am Erica Lee Hammond. I actually am the co-star of The Sin Reapers. I play Pandora Crane.
Okay, tell my audience about your character.
Well, I'm his partner and his lover. We basically go around together, the souls of any murdered victims or people who need revenge, they call to us. And we basically go out and exact revenge for them in the most brutal ways possible.
Scary. Oh, boy. Tell my audience where we could go to find out more information. Do you guys have a website?
Yes, we do. It's www.fortefilmsentertainment.com. We also have a Facebook page there with the same name. It's a Twitter page, Forte Films Ent, Kevin Forte. You'll find us there. And
how do you spell your name?
F-O-R-T-E. Okay. So Forte Films Entertainment, the website, you see all our projects, and more up on the Sin Reapers, because it's going to be a web series, so more episodes will be coming in of The Adventures of Jared Scrim and Pandora Crane.
Are you up for any awards tonight?
I know that Wednesday's Children's up for award for one of the best actresses in it. The Sin Reapers, we're the people's champ. The people's champ.
Well, we're going to take a look at the film, and we're going to judge for ourselves what is good and what is bad, and thank you so much for taking the time to talk to me right here at the Macaw Fair Film Festival. We'll be back in a moment, darlings. More interviews coming up. Keep watching. Pink Champagne Kisses.
Get out of my house!
I'm Cognac Willelane, and we are here at the Macaw Fair Film Festival, and I'm here with actor Mr. Edward X. Young. He's a horror celebrity, and he's here with his good friend. Introduce yourself.
Tom Ryan.
Tell my audience about, you're doing a film, right? You're here for a specific film, or did you just come to enjoy the fair?
Well, I come to every Macabre Fair event.
Yes, I know that.
And in 2013, I did win the award for Best Actor for The Green Monster.
Yes, I remember that.
And almost every year they have at least one or two or even three of my pictures here. This year they're actually not screening any of my movies, but I was the victim of the celebrity roast Friday night, which was a great honor.
Well, you are a celebrity. Now tell my audience, why are you here tonight?
In the winter 2015 Macabre Fair, we won Audience Choice Best Feature. I also won Best Actor, and tonight.
Tell my audience your names.
Oh, my name is Tom Ryan, and the film is Faces, and Mr. Edward X. Young here was also my co-star in that film, and I won Best Actor, and the Macabites, which are the judges from last year's festival, voted on the Best Actor overall over the festivals in 2015, and I won that award tonight, and that's why I'm here.
Spectacular.
Tom Ryan, I must say, he's too modest, and I mean this with all sincerity, I'm not kidding. Tom Ryan may be the, you could call him the Orson Welles of independent horror cinema, because he does it all. He produces, writes, directs, and acts in his own movies. And then he also goes forward to win the acclaim and the nominations and often the awards for producing, directing, writing, and acting in the same movie. He's a powerhouse of talent, and I'm very proud to have been in his movie Faces as one of the supporting actors, which was the big, big award winner last year, and just secured a distribution deal, which you should be...
Wow!
Thank you, Ed.
Congratulations!
Thank you very much.
Tell my audience where we could go to find out more information about you as an actor, a horror celebrity. Where can we go? What's your website?
Well, I mean, I have an open Facebook page, Edward X. Young. Don't forget the middle initial. Most of my stuff there is easily readable to anybody. It's free. I don't have any blocks on it. And also, you can look me up on IMDb. But you can look up my individual and specific projects. I've acted, done makeup, or directed 74 movies in the past 11 years, and I've got a lot of big projects are coming out this year. Right now you can go to Best Buy and find Flesh for the Beast, Tsukiko's Curse, which is a horror miniseries, available only at Best Buy. And you can find my movie Paranormal Captivity in video stores everywhere. Recently it was picked, Wild Eye sold it to Germany, It's been dubbed into German. It'll be on German TV under the title of Paranormal Investigations Part 9. But I've got a lot of movies, a lot of places. Look up my name. You could find a lot of trailers on...
We will. We will. What about you, darling? Tell my audience the website.
If you want to find anything on our films, our independent films, it's theaterofterror.net. And that's theater is spelled T-H-E-A-T-R-E, not E-R, it's R-E, .net. And check us out. You can order the films or just follow what we're doing and what projects we're up to and keep tabs on our production. Horror, viva la indie horror.
Break a leg, guys. Give me a kiss. We'll be back in a moment, darlings. Our interview's coming up. Keep watching. Pink Champagne Kisses.
Always a thrill to be interviewed by you.
My name is Frank Walker. Life has never been easy for me. I have no job, no friends, no girlfriend. But then everything changed when I met Charlie.
In a moment, darlings. Our interview's coming up. Keep watching. Pink Champagne Kisses.
This has been a Crybaby Productions, darlings.